Maiki is always in search of calibers, yet he finds none.
You can shout now. That can only mean one thing. You must be Dragonborn. Captain, what should we do? It's not on the list. To the block, prisoner. Nice and easy.
Welcome. Let me know if you want anything. I think I've got a clean mug around here somewhere.
Ah, our dreamer is waking up. I'll get some water and bread, then. That'll be another 4 gold coins, Hurlis.
Yes, yes. You'll get your money. You're even worse than a Khajiit. I have told you that he will wake up today, at the latest. Fever seems to fade. Can you see my hand? Considering how long you were down with fever, you should be glad that you didn't grow Falmarize. It's because of you that I'm stuck in this jerkwater town for a week now. I'll tell you if you tell me who I have to thank for that. If I were you, I'd show more gratitude. But what can you expect of an adventurer? Always hunting for easy pickings, but when they run into trouble, they're stumped. I am Hurlis. If you make a deal with the Daedra, I'll plunge my sword into your chest straight away. I have devoted my life to serving Stendar. I found you, unconscious, on the shore of the Karth River. Not responsive, seriously hypothermic, trembling all over. Stendar, be my witness, when I held your cold body in my arms, I hardly gave you an hour. Tell me, what has happened to you? I'm sure it wasn't a skeever. You had not a single scratch. That amulet, yes, you were wearing it. It feels oddly heavy and radiates an unusual chill. What worries me more are these runes on the amulet. Undoubtedly Daedric. While you were down with fever, and I was stuck in this hole because of you, I tried to decipher some of the runes. However, I do not have sufficient command of the Daedric language. I could only make out the name of Count Charis of Meresis. Meresis is the Breton, but nowadays hardly used term, for the region west of Solitude. A count who engraves his name on some strange amulet in a Daedric tone. Very odd. Besides, it seems to me that there is another part of this amulet. Some kind of stone. Behold the hole in the middle.
I'm
Stendar's mercy upon you, for the vigil has none to spare. Can you hear me? Stendar be praised, you're alive. Are you okay? You were unconscious again. I'm afraid you'll have to stay here for a few more days to recover. The amulet. Did you feel it too? The icy chill. It was gone. It was glowing. Warm. This thing is dangerous. I'm almost sure that this is one of those Daedric objects. As a precaution, I should take it and let one of my friars examine it. We used to deal with objects like this every day. Well, I will show it to the experts. I'm quite sure they can solve this amulet's enigma. White Claw? I don't know. Who told you about that? It must have spoken to you. Yes? That would make sense. You have heard that voice too, haven't you? I heard words in some strange tongue, but it seemed distracted, as if its attention was drawn away towards something else. But I could hear a weak, no, fragile voice whispering something about a White Claw. I don't know, but that could be possible.
I'm sorry to barge in. I couldn't avoid overhearing your conversation. It seems you have a problem there. What can one expect when messing around with magic? A few weeks ago, it was already late, and business went bad that evening. One of these sailors sat here, hooked on alcohol and dead drunk, of course. What am I saying? These are my most treasured guests. He babbled weird stuff the whole evening. Complained to me about his buddy not showing up, mentioning a White Claw again and again. If you're interested, he forgot some notes that evening. I was about to throw them away, but for 300 gold coins, they're yours. 100 coins a chit. How's it going? Ah, brilliant. The price is right. I wish you much fun on the treasure hunt. Oh, I almost forgot. This room you've been keeping occupied for quite a while now will cost you another 70 gold coins.
Stendar's mercy upon you, for the vigil has none to spare. If my assumptions prove right, your find may help you recover a bit. One more thing. Better make haste. Experience has taught me that Daedric artifacts should never be taken lightly. Take this amulet of Stendar, may his hand protect you. In the meantime, I will ask my order for advice. I think I can tell you more in a few days. I'll be waiting for you in Whiterun at the Gildergreen Tree. Farewell, and watch yourself.
Your skin's as pale as the snow. You scared of sunlight? Something? Fate is the name. In. Oh.
Thank you.
There you are. When I saw you step out of that door in Dragonbridge, well, admittedly, I didn't believe we'd ever meet again. But now, you're looking even worse than you did in that village. Tell me, how did you do? Let me see. Yes, it would fit the socket perfectly, but I'm afraid without the proper magical abilities, it won't be too easy to join the stone and socket. Do you have a plan to free your soul from that beast's claws? So that white claw thing, it was a failure? I, for one, cannot see how that stone is supposed to get us any further. While you were away, I did ask my order for advice. It was like always, you know. First, they let you wait for hours. Then they hardly take you seriously, just to diagnose a faulty enchantment. A faulty enchantment! You know I felt it. Stendar, have mercy, that damn thing. I saw a black door, an inexplicable strong wind. I passed out, just like you. Why are these bookworms always the ones to deliver the important judgments? I can already feel Vermina outstretching her hands for me. Listen to me. There is another person I could consult. Exactly. It won't be easy, but I think he can be convinced. My former mentor. He left the Order 20 years ago. In his eyes, the Circle was not acting radically enough against the Daedra. If it had been up to him, the Order would have turned against any Daedra worship, demolished the shrines, and burned the cultists to death. Let me mark his last known residence on your map. You must meet me there. I'm afraid this is our only choice. Finally. Do I look like one of these Nords that can be left waiting in the cold for days? Finally. Well, here we are. He's living up there in the old lighthouse. You know, it's more than 20 years ago that I last saw Zarador. He was excitable back then. Well, a typical high elf, you know. I suggest you contain yourself and let me do the talking. Lighthouse over there. I never understood why he settled down here after his escape from the Order. But the company of men never did do him any good.
What is your business here, Perlis? What are you doing here? Who is this stranger? You. Go away. Leave my house immediately.
Please calm down, Zarador. You really haven't changed a bit.
Get out!
I beg you to wait and listen. We just want to have a short word with you. See? I even brought the canis root I forgot the last time we met.
Don't make a fool out of yourself. That's 20 years ago now. Now get lost!
Zarador, won't you at least listen to us for a short moment? This stranger here has made his way from Leowyn to meet a former member of the Circle.
It's just like back then when you got your mind set on something. Leowyn, you say? A gorgeous city. If If only I could once again smell the scent of the alkanet flower I used to love as a 5-year-old boy. So what's the matter?
Well, this stranger here, nota bene the dragonborn, has found this amulet and the matching stone.
Oh, I knew it.
Be that as it may, this amulet seems to emit a certain, probably Daedric, viciousness. I found my friend a few days ago unconscious. I'm sure that it is all connected to this amulet. If you would just cast a short glance at the fragments, I'm confident this would clarify things for us.
I've heard of this piece of jewelry. Let me see. Yes. Oh, yes, it bears the same symbols it should. Up there, is that a Daedric O? No, that looks more like a P to me. I think the inscription reads something like, Count Karis of Meresis, bound to eternally serve Bar Karur. Very interesting.
Yes, Charis of Meresis. I had that deciphered too, but instead of Bar Karur,
I bet you got the Baof, the first two symbols mixed up with the Parons again. Bar Karur, that would be... No, that would be the almost forgotten name of Molech Bal, the Daedric Prince of Slavery and Discord.
Meresis, wasn't that the early name of the region west of Solitude?
Yes, that is correct. I'm afraid what we have here is the Amulet of Meresis. Incredible. Legend to this amulet is as follows. I assume that you've heard that more than 200 years ago, the border between this world, Mundus, and the world of Oblivion, the Daedra Plains, was fragile and thin like never before. This era is generally referred to as the Oblivion Crisis, because the Daedric Prince of Destruction, Maedhros Dagon, used that thin border to dare an invasion on Temriel. Times must have been exciting, just perfect to contact the Daedra. It is said that Molech Bal spoke to Count Karis in his dreams. He offered him the occasion of immortality in this life, achieved by an invocation on an amulet to trap his soul. But Molech Bal, the Prince of Slavery and Discord, giving a present to mortals, the Count had been betrayed. The broken fragments henceforth served the Daedric Prince as a tool to enslave mortals, to draw their souls into the realm of Oblivion. Having a look at you, I can tell that you don't look so healthy either.
But there must be a possibility to avoid that.
A Daedric artifact. Tricky. No, impossible. The amulet is broken. In this state, it is impossible to break the charm.
So, I guess the shell must be joined.
You're joking. That wouldn't just be complicated, but utterly risky.
But if it's the only way...
But if it's the only way, well, we would need a soul gem, or the container in which the soul that was used to enchant this amulet was trapped. However, where could we possibly find something like that? Well, I ask myself if it would make sense to search in an old Jarl dynasty manor. It seems like no one set a foot in the castle for more than 200 years, so there might be a connection to the amulet. I hear that a gruesome shadow is walking abroad there. Well, in the end, it is your decision to make. All that amulet stuff is none of my business anyway. And I think it is time for you to go.
I understand. Thank you for your time. I'm afraid you have to go into the castle alone. I can hardly stand on my feet since last night. I had that same dream again. Thank you. The suffering the Daedra caused will not go unpunished.
So the old man locked you up in here, didn't he? Pelagius always knew it would return. Hey, you, place yourself in the middle of the hall. Are you Argonian? Let me have a look at you so I can welcome you in your native tongue. May I introduce myself? I am Pelagius the Third, or according to my old Potema, Pelagius the Mad. Oh, nothing really. Just has been here before. The old Sarador been here before. So, what? Oh, but Pelagius knows what you mean, but won't tell. Not as long as the pompous festivity here endures. Oh, the pompous festivity on which I tried to hang myself. Can't you see the rope over there? If Aunt Potima hadn't dished up with that awful snowberry pie, it wouldn't have come to this. But the rope. And her hideous relatives are gone. Oh, I know. The stone. Ah. Well, he is gone. Been removed by the old man. Gray hair, bald headed. Looked like Uncle Zephyrus. But he has fallen off a horse. Away, gone, not there anymore. Away, gone, not there anymore. Well, through the door, of course. The one only Pelagius knows. Oh, won't tell. Oh, won't tell. You gotta make an effort, you know? Oh, you're smarter than Pelagius assumed. You're smarter than Pelagius assumed. The equilibrium. Pelagius already passed out on his coronation. The equilibrium. Here, above the ceiling, there is a winder. Turn Pelagius to the right. much better. Plagius. Exit. Attention. Up there are 12 numbered bookshelves, on one of which there is a special book that will help you. The number of the shelf is a prime number. Take the cross total of the sum of the prime numbers there, so the number of the shelf you're looking for cannot be expressed through a difference of this cross total and another one of the prime numbers up there. And note that the number of the shelf you're searching for is not divisible by two. Don't you find that riddle as delicious as I do? That same old story over again. Up there are 12 numbered bookshelves, on one of which there is a special book that will help you. The number, huh? Oh, of course. But you must do me a favor, you know? Pelagius loves bird eggs. Even since he was a child, he loved crushing them under his feet. Bring me some from the castle tower, and the ladies will help you. Pelagius wishes you good luck.
You're alive? You have... How is this possible? Everything was sealed. Wait, let me explain. Don't kill me. Without me, you cannot be released from this amulet. Yes. Yes, I confess, I was sure you'd meet your doom in that castle. But will you listen to me? It was me, more than 200 years ago. I enchanted the amulet. All that happened is my fault. Give me a moment. Let me start from the beginning. It was up to me to do the invocation, for I was on the Count's service as a mage. Driven by unbounded ambition and blindness, I inverted the ritual. His soul was trapped inside the amulet for all eternity, and instead of him, I received the gift of eternal life. And that is the reason why the amulet broke. But both of us were betrayed, the Count and myself. How could we enter a pact with Molag Bal? I regret everything I did. Since that day, my life turned into a nightmare. Since that day, I keep having the same dream each and every night. I see myself sitting next to the fire. You are coming through the door holding the fragments of the amulet in your hand. I can see myself helping you joining the amulet. It's getting dark. A pitch black door, a black corridor, some inexplicable wind coming up. Then I wake, shivering all over my body. I've spent my life trying to find out how to undo all this. The amulet is a first-hand gift straight from Molag Bal. It cannot be melted down just like any other ordinary piece of jewelry. I fear it can be destroyed in our world. It must be banished to Molag Bal's realm. In one piece. In one piece. That is the problem. You know, I know it's the end. By assembling the fragments, they lose their manipulative effect, and my life would be finite again. I was afraid. Afraid of what may come afterwards, though. I wished for nothing so much than to undo my mistake. So I sent you to the castle. There is nothing but dust and cobwebs. And shadows. I'm so sorry. At that moment, I hoped to escape my faith by making one more mistake. I will help you assemble the amulet. That is not so easy. Nowadays, there are hardly any bridges to the realms of oblivion. Perhaps you've heard of the Oblivion Gates. They were such bridges. Or you've heard of a strange gate in Nibbon Bay in Cyrodiil that was said to lead into the realm of Sheogorath. These were such transitions, and that's exactly what you need to bring the amulet into the Oblivion realms after I joined the fragments. I've been searching it for a long time. Perhaps you've heard of the legendary Corrington Mirror, described by Syfij Hyja in his book, The Doors of Oblivion. It is still considered missing, but I think I've found clues on its whereabouts. It all seems that it is in Ar-Karanak. It is an ancient city close to the Hammerfell frontier. It's the home of the Ragada, the ancestors of today's Red Guards. The exact location will hopefully be revealed in this book. Give me the amulet. Molag Bal shall get what he demands. Follow me.
voices. Yes, yes, I remember. I can recall. I found you unconscious. Leave this place. Leave. Carlos. Carlos? Oh, yes. I remember that Stendar gave me that name. Stendar. What has happened? Oh, I recall that element. This element. These voices. I can't stand them any longer. Something's calling me. Give me the amulet. Farewell. May Stendar be with you.